Substitution effect, Slutsky version. Already I uploaded Hicks version. The link is given in the description. This lesson is about Slutsky version of substitution effect. We shall start. Given the prices of two goods and income, the consumer is in equilibrium at point E1, where IC1 is tangent to the price line AB. He consumes M1 units of good X and M2 units of good Y. The income of the consumer and price of good Y remaining constant, there is a fall in the price of good X. The price line rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. The new price line AB2, relatively flat, is formed. The slope reflects the relative cheapness of good X. After a fall in the price of good X, the consumer will buy more of good X because of two reasons. Relative cheapness of good X, it is substitution effect. Increase in the purchasing power, it is income effect. Slutsky wants to do away with income effect in deriving the valid demand theory. He eliminates the increase in the quantity that takes place due to increase in the real income of the consumer by reducing the income by cost difference. Income of the consumer reduced by such an amount that will enable the consumer to go back to his original equilibrium point and buy the original bundle of goods is called reduction in income by cost difference. The new price line is A1, B1. Consumer cannot be in equilibrium at E1 because price line A1, B1 cuts IC1 at that point. He cannot be in equilibrium in any point in the segment E1, A1 because it will place him on a lower indifference curve. He can be in equilibrium only in the segment that lies below E1. His new equilibrium is at E2, where IC2 is tangent to the price line A1, B1. He buys M2 units of good X and N1 units of good Y. The consumer slides down along the price line by substituting M1, M2 units of good X in the place of N1, N2 units of good Y. This is substitution effect. According to Slutsky, it is substitution effect that makes a consumer always buy more after a fall in price. In other words, the negative slope of the demand curve or negative relation between price and quantity demanded is mainly due to substitution effect. Let us derive the Slutsky demand curve graphically. We shall do it with two graphs. In the top part, we have figure A. This is the figure we used so far in our discussion. In the bottom part, there is figure B showing only two axes of graph. We shall use it to derive the demand curve. From figure A, we know at P2 price, the consumer consumes M1 units. Let us plot that point on the figure B and name the point as F. The price falls to P1. After eliminating the income effect, due to substitution effect, the consumer buys M2 units. At P1 price, the consumer buys M2 units. Let us plot this data also in figure B. Name the point as G. Join these two points. The resultant curve is Slutsky's cost difference demand curve. Our lesson ends here. We shall meet again to compare Hicksian substitution effect with Slutsky's substitution effect.